Dr. King once said, our lives begin to end the day we become silent about things that matter. On Thursday, June 29, 2017, Aaron Bailey was shot and killed in our city as a result of a police action shooting. He was unarmed. The precise facts of that incident are under investigation, both administratively and criminally. As part of that investigation, the important question will be what specific set of circumstances that night led to Aaron Bailey's death. The Marion County Prosecutor's Office will consider the answer to that question and make determinations. In addition, a comprehensive administrative review of the facts of the matter will be conducted, and it is my responsibility to ensure that those efforts will be conducted and completed expeditiously, with as much openness and transparency as due process allows. However, underlying what happened that night lies a much broader and deeper and no less important question. What broader set of circumstances must we see, must we understand, and most importantly, must acknowledge in considering what happened that night? Circumstances that involve race and history in America. On July 4, mere days after this tragedy, I served as a participant in a naturalization ceremony conducted by the Honorable Sarah Evans Barker, Federal District Court Judge of the Southern District of Indiana. I watched person after person raise their right hand and swear an oath to this country. With their families beside them, they proudly smiled and laughed with joy, achieving for many what was a long-held dream. In taking that oath and in becoming citizen, sets of rights and responsibilities were bestowed upon them. But that's not all. For those rights and responsibilities are born of a raw and real history. And in being or becoming an American, we all inherit that history. And we inherit all of it. I note this because it is precisely that point, a failure by some to acknowledge all of our past, that so often explains the distrust and the divisions that beset our cities and our nation. Distrust and division between white and black, between rich and poor, between community and law enforcement. If the words of the Declaration of Independence, that all men are created equal with a right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, are etched on tattered parchments and marble monuments, so must we equally bear witness to the fact that we have yet to fully live up to them. President Barack Obama, when discussing race in America, once quoted the novelist William Faulkner. Faulkner had said, "The past isn't dead. It isn't even past." Prejudice, poverty, humiliation, hate, pain, loss, slavery, Jim Crow, lynching, segregation, mass incarceration, assassination. All perpetuated by the relevant contemporaneous authority in America. As a nation and as a city, we must acknowledge that history, all of us, and the fear and the distrust that comes with it. All of us. And it starts with me. If a community does not bear witness together, if it chooses to look the other way, it risks its very soul. In Indianapolis, we must choose now and in the future to acknowledge the past, all of it, and we must choose to address it head on so that the past will not repeat itself. In the coming days, I will outline specific steps the city of Indianapolis will take to meaningfully respond to our community's concerns. Those steps will involve embracing systemic change. And in the months to follow, we will carry out those steps. It will be hard. I have no illusion. And it certainly won't happen overnight. But we must be serious, judicious, transparent, objective, and fair. Indeed, not everyone will agree with the decisions I make. I'm used to that. And on that point, permit me to offer just a few observations about this ongoing community conversation. As I consider and determine the broad course of action we take as a community, what I will not be persuaded by is posturing. In response to the events of June 29, I have heard some in our community, not many, but some, who have suggested in full confidence that as tragic and as unfortunate as the situation may be, nothing, at least fundamentally, nothing is wrong. That while unfortunate, nothing needs to change. They did so reactively, without knowing or considering the entirety of the facts. Early on, an investigation had not even begun, and yet conclusions had already been made. In my mind, advocacy of the status quo ante is unfortunate and serves only to underscore the distrust that many feel. If we truly care about the rule of law, in law and in order, then I would strongly suggest that such voices cannot prevail. But neither can we stand silent while some others, in immediate response to the events of June 29th, demanded the immediate criminal indictment, prosecution, conviction, termination, and other sanctions of all of those involved. Again, not a single person knew all of the facts with formal inquiries not even begun, and yet conclusions have already been drawn. My friends, perceived justice born of historic injustice is not justice at all. It is nothing more than revenge, and it threatens to drown out those who seek what is true, what is real, what is right. Dr. King reminds us, darkness cannot drive out darkness, only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. On June 29th, 2017, an unarmed African-American man was shot and killed in the city of Indianapolis. I happened to be the mayor. I cannot undo what occurred on June 29th any more than I can remake our past. But I must be held accountable for what happened on June 29th, 2017, and I am accountable. I must acknowledge that when lights come on in a rearview mirror, a fear and distrust born of years of incontrovertible prejudice and abuse exists. And I do acknowledge that. I must commit to doing everything in my power to change whatever is wrong wherever it exists, with no sacred cows, and I will. What I can't do is promise this city will never again experience tragedy or injustice. It probably will. But that does not make it acceptable. Yesterday, I spent the morning going from worship service to worship service to worship service to worship service. I left my home early yesterday morning, weary. I returned to my home and wrote these remarks. Our community always sustains me. I'm not certain we can make this country or this city perfect, but I do believe deep in my heart that we can and will make it better, more just, more safe, or prosperous. I do believe deep in my heart that we can give our children a better life than we inherited. I do believe deep in my heart we are one city. I thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, such a strong, powerful, and candid words from Mayor Joe Hogsett this morning. Another round of applause for the Mayor of Indianapolis.
Then it's time to begin our awards presentation. So Mayor Hogsett and Tanya Bell, please join us for the presentation of awards to our 2017 recipients. Our first award today is the Mayor's Emerging Business Award, and it is being presented to Viable and